Hey, thanks for coming by Tori Magoo 44, February 5th, and this is a video on Anonymous and Scientology. As most of you know, with Scientology and Anonymous, of course there's Anonymous, first of all, as a all over the world that do all kinds of different things. This is regarding the Anonymous group that started picketing the Church of Scientology and exposing all of their abuses, okay? And this weekend coming up is their second year anniversary. It's our second year anniversary. I feel like, you know, we've all been a part of it with the ex-Scientologists, the critics, and Anonymous. But they have been fantastic. You have been fantastic. The people that are Anonymous and have been part of this, I cannot thank you enough. I've learned a bunch of things from you. One of the very first things they taught me, here you go. You ready? I'll tell you what it is. Now hang on just one second. You're going to recognize it. Don't hang up. Don't go away. Rick Ashley. I mean, it's called a Rick Roll for anybody new. And Anonymous, when I first met them, they were doing this all over the world and in a lot of their videos. The funny thing now is that in a lot of grocery stores and things, and even in the mall the other day, they're playing that song. It's hysterical. It really is. They have done some amazing things. But a couple of the major things that happened. First of all, when I met Anonymous, we went for a walk around the complex here in Los Angeles. And just as a perspective of it, previous to that, we had been picketing ex-Scientologists and critics. I'd say, you know, we generally have anywhere from 5 to 10, 15 to maybe 20, 25 people at the most. That was our biggest picket, right? So I meet with Anonymous, we walk around the complex, and they say, okay, we're going to do it. And, you know, we're going to have a picket. And I say, okay, cool. And they go, yeah, we'll have about 500 people. And I'm like, sure, yeah, right. I mean, I had no clue what was coming, right? So Mark Bunker, me, Rowan, a couple other people, we all, you know, get our picket signs and we go down to the subway. We're going to meet him down on Vermont. We get onto the subway. And first of all, here's these guys. See the mask up here? They've all got on their masks on the subway and black suits. They look fabulous. And they're all sitting there very peacefully. And we get on the subway and I can feel the people are just like, ah! You know, just kind of freaked out. And I said, ladies and gentlemen, these people are going to be picketing the Church of Scientology. Everything is just fine. And there's this big like, phew, you know, kind of a relief. Because here in LA, people, different things can happen. And I don't think they knew what was going down. So we get off the subway. I mean, that was our first meeting with these guys in their outfits. They look terrific. We get off thinking, okay, maybe there's going to be 30 more people down by the complex. We get off wrong. 500 people are at the complex. It was fantastic. That was in February 2008. Since then, and that very picket, which I will put a video up over there, of the final version of that picket around the world, there were 9,000 plus people. And of course, they mentioned with everybody behind the scenes that helped out, it was many thousands more. But it was 9,000 people picketing. And if you've seen that video, watch it again. It is a great video. And if you came, come again. It's the second year anniversary. You gotta come. It was an amazing experience. And for the people that have helped and continued to expose the abuses of the Church of Scientology, I can't thank you enough. I mean, so many things have come out of it. First of all, a number of different executives from the Church of Scientology have left, including Marty Rathbun, who's on Nightline, Mike Rinder, who is the head of PR, Blown for Good, was working up at Gold, their top secret location, for 15 years. And we knew he knew a lot of stuff because he was posting as Blown for Good. But he came out, he's Mark Headley, and he wrote the book Blown for Good. And it's now, you can buy it at blownforgood.com. Nancy Maney also has a fantastic story. She was Catherine's story up on Xenu.net. And she's written her book, My Billion Year Contract. And you can see that at mybillionyearcontract.com. Some other people that have happily left: Jeff Hawkins, Larry Brennan, Maria in Italy wrote her book and sent me a copy. Thank you so much. I mean, it's just so much stuff has gone down. The ex-Scientology kids, they made a website, and tons of young people have been able to tell their stories of what happened to them with Scientology, which is a lot. The media all over the world have just gotten fantastic, you know, exposure to what's going on, and they have come way up to speed to where they are really interviewing people and giving them a platform and letting them speak and tell what really happened. As a result of that, you know, Anonymous has made tons and tons of fantastic videos. And as a result of all these things and more, I'm sure I'm forgetting to mention all the OT8s who left recently. It's terrific. I mean, it's just been, it's like a snowball. I said that in the beginning. It's like you get it going, it gets a little bigger, it gets a little bigger, and then pretty soon it's out of control. And that's the way it is. It is just happening. So I hope you take the time this weekend to come, either Friday, I think Friday, you can go to SoCal Anon. I'll put a link up there, which will show you for the Southern California thing, what's going on Friday, Saturday, and I think Sunday morning. And then you can always go to whyweprotest.net, because they've got all around the world. You can check out what state, you know, or what country you're from, what city they're going to be in, what times they're going to be in. And come. Even if you come for a few hours, come. Because the more, the merrier. And it really is. And, you know, you have helped a ton of people. Whether you know it or not, you, and I'm talking to you, you, the person listening to you, yes. Whether you even didn't even come to the picket, maybe you just post on YouTube or on Facebook or on one of the websites, it helps people. I told you, I've told this story more than once, but it's one I love, where a girl just a couple of months ago, they were picketing outside, and she picked up a phone and called her mom and said, come pick me up. She said, I realized I could be out there with those people, and they're having such a good time. So, you know, you never know who you're going to help. There's a great book called The Power of One. I highly recommend you read it also, because you never know. There is such a power in things you're doing. So please come and enjoy yourself and have a wonderful time. And I love you all. Thank you so much. Peace out. Have a great weekend and a safe weekend.